Now, let me discuss the algorithm for the treatment of congestive heart failure. So, if you see this algorithm, first, as and when, once the diagnosis of the heart failure, if it is confirmed, you just assess if there is any fluid retention. Because in patients with the congestive heart failure, due to left heart failure, there will be pulmonary congestion, and due to right heart failure, there will be systemic congestion. So once the diagnosis of the heart failure is confirmed by various methodologies of the diagnosis, you assess whether there is any fluid retention. Now, how will you assess whether the individual has the fluid retention? Now, for example, if the individual is having the left heart failure, you have to look for if there is any crepitations within the lung with the help of the stethoscope. So that will tell you that there is pulmonary congestion. Now, in patients with right heart failure, you will see that there will be either raised JVP or presence of tender hepatomegaly or presence of the pedal edema. So this will tell you that the individual is having systemic congestion. So this is how you have to assess the fluid retention. So once you have assessed the fluid retention, if there is fluid retention in the patient, you have to give the diuretics first. Remember, if there is fluid retention, the drugs what you have to give is diuretics. Now, if there is no fluid retention, then the drugs what you have to give is AC inhibitors. Remember, AC inhibitors are very important drugs in patients with the congestive cardiac failure. But you have to look whether there is any fluid retention. If there is any fluid retention, try and give the diuretics first. And then once the fluid retention is solved, then you go ahead and give this particular AC inhibitors. So AC inhibitors, remember, they will improve the survival of the patient. They will reverse the cardiac remodeling. That is the purpose why we have to give AC inhibitors in patients with the congestive cardiac failure. Until unless they are contraindicated, you have to give the AC inhibitors. Now, along with AC inhibitors, you have to give the beta blockers. And remember an important point, AC inhibitors should be given in all the classes of the congestive cardiac failure. You take class 1 NYHA, you take class 2 NYHA, class 3 NYHA and class 4 NYHA, that is New York Heart Association classification, you have to give the AC inhibitors. Now, along with AC inhibitors, what we give is the beta blockers. Now, remember, beta blockers we give in all the classes of the congestive cardiac failure except for your decompensated heart failure. In decompensated heart failure, we don't give this particular beta blockers. Now, you take these beta blockers. Now, what are those group of beta blockers which are very important? I have said you that bisoprolol, metoprolol, and as well as carvedilol. These are the important beta blockers. And what is the purpose of giving beta blockers? Mainly to neutralize that increase in the sympathetic outflow, you have to give this beta blockers. And remember, beta blockers are also the group of drugs which will improve the survival of the patient. Next, the other group of drugs what we give is, once you have given AC inhibitors, you have given beta blockers, if the patient is asymptomatic, that means if the symptoms of the individual is controlled, then continue that AC inhibitors and beta blockers. But if the symptoms are persisting, right? If the symptoms are persisting, then you have to give the other group of drugs that includes your aldosterone antagonist. That is, either your spironolactone or eplerenone should be added to your ACE inhibitor and as well as beta blocker. And the other drugs what we can give if the symptoms are persisting is, we can also give the hydralazine, which is an arteriolar vasodilator which will reduce the afterload of the individual. And the other drugs include the isosorbide nitrate. These nitrates, they will reduce the preload on the heart and thereby they will reduce the myocardial oxygen demand. And the other group of drugs is your digoxin. Digoxin, it will increase the cardiac contractility and thereby it will reduce the congestive symptoms. So This is the algorithm for treatment of heart failure. I'll repeat. So once the diagnosis of the heart failure is confirmed, you assess if there is any fluid retention. If there is any fluid retention, you have to give the diuretic. If there is no fluid retention, you have to give the ACE inhibitors. You can give this in all the classes of heart failure until unless contraindicated. And then you have to give the beta blockers. If the individual is asymptomatic, well and good, you can continue the ACE inhibitors and beta blockers. But in spite of giving ACE inhibitors and beta blockers, if the individual is still symptomatic, and this is the point when you have to add the aldosterone antagonist or your hydralazine, which is an arteriolar vasodilator, which will reduce the afterload, or you should add the nitrates, which will reduce the preload on the patient heart, and you should also add digoxin. So this particular digoxin will improve the cardiac contractility, but it will not increase the myocardial oxygen demand. So these are the things like what you have to do if the symptoms are still persisting in patients with the congestive cardiac failure.